How's it going, guys? It's Josh here. So welcome to my 2017 room tour. We just hit 5,000 subscribers, which is absolutely insane. So I thought I'd do a bit of a special video. I hope you all enjoy. So if I'm not at work or with friends, this is where I tend to spend most of my time. It's essentially three separate rooms, a main office area, a bedroom, and the ensuite bathroom. So the office is where I normally film videos, you guys tend to only see the desk area, but on the other side of the room we have a white leather sofa along with a mini fridge, a coffee machine and an RGB lamp. Oh, and we also have this sick canvas picture of a cat wearing sunglasses. I've fitted LEDs to the bottom of the sofa to give it a nice underglow. These can be voice controlled via the Amazon Echo, which I'll come to in a moment. I decided to go for a white and glass coffee table to match with the sofa. There's normally a mini wireless keyboard with a trackpad on here too, in case I ever want to control the PC from the sofa. It definitely comes in handy. You probably also noticed the Iron Man helmet hiding on the bottom shelf. So the other side of the office leads through to the bedroom. Now I was going for the minimalist look here, so I went for a grey and white colour scheme. The back of the wardrobe also features some LED strips just to give a nice ambient glow at night. They're actually the same ones I use on the back of my desk. I'll talk a bit more about them in just a minute. The only other thing to really mention in this room is the really cool canvas I picked up off eBay, and I also hung one of my guitars on the wall. I do like the fact that the main room and the bedroom are separated. I could have used the main room as the bedroom, but I just didn't really see the point in using up loads of space for somewhere you only sleep. I wanted to keep the larger room as more of a recreation and gaming area. So the actual setup. So I have four displays in total. On the bottom we have three 27-inch monitors from Asus. If you're interested in the model name, they're the VN279QLB. I went for these simply because of the very slim bezels and also the fact that they are DisplayPort. If you are doing a multi-monitor setup, I'd definitely recommend DisplayPort monitors over HDMI, as most GPUs nowadays have multiple DisplayPort connectors, not HDMI. It saves faffing about with adapters and converters. Up top we have a 55-inch smart TV from Sony. This is connected to the PC, however if I do use it, it's normally for playing games that use a controller or watching movies, in which case I'll either sit on the sofa or recline the chair and put my feet up on the desk. I could have mounted it just above the monitors, but I kind of wanted it to look like a separate TV rather than a fourth monitor, as it's a bit ridiculous having a 55-inch display as a monitor. To the left of the desk we have a round glass table. This is just where I tend to put everyday tech stuff, power banks, Bluetooth speakers, headphones, stuff that I use on a daily basis. I've got a racing chair from GT Omega. I'm pretty happy with it for the most part. It offers a high level of comfort at a fairly reasonable price, and it's great for playing games or watching movies. On the desk we have the Logitech G903 mouse, a Moto Speed CK98 keyboard, and a wireless fast charger, all of which are sat on top of the MM300 extended mouse mat from Corsair. I also drilled a hole in the desk to route cables through for that super clean look. The desk itself is the 98-inch Colby countertop from IKEA, which I've got sat on top of the Alex drawers. A lot of people ask me about the LED strips on the back of the desk. They're called Dream Color LED strips. You can set different parts of the strip to different colours, allowing you to achieve that rainbow look. I recently changed my speakers. I was using some Rocket 5 studio monitors from KRK, but I switched to these slightly smaller monitor speakers from Pioneer. They're black and white, which just went better with the setup, and they sound great. You might have noticed these sensors behind the monitors. I did pick up an Oculus Rift a few months back, and I've enjoyed my time with it so far. I'm a big fan of Elite Dangerous. If you're not familiar with it, it's essentially a space flight sim, so I'll usually sit in the chair, grab the HOTAS controller, and play in VR. I have done a fair bit of room scale stuff too. Lone Echo is a fantastic game if you've not played it. So the PC powering this whole setup is a custom built one that I've kind of just upgraded over the years. It's currently got an i5-6500 in it paired with a GTX 1080 from Nvidia. It doesn't really have any problems with gaming at all, although I am wanting to upgrade to an i7 very soon for the purpose of video editing. Now to me, lighting really makes a huge difference in any room, and along with all the LED strips and RGB lamps, I recently fitted out this whole floor with smart bulbs, which I've got hooked up to the Amazon Echo. Seven of them are Philips Hue bulbs. They're the recessed GU10 type, the seven altogether, three in the bathroom, three in the bedroom, and one above the sofa. The ones in the bedroom and bathroom are hooked up to a motion sensor, so when I walk in the room, they turn on. The thing I like about these bulbs is that you can change the brightness and the colour temperature, so you can achieve a nice level of ambience. The main light in the office area is a Lifex Colour 1000 bulb. It's extremely bright and you can change the colour of it to whatever you want. I normally only have it set to 50% though, because it floods the room with light. Like I said before, all of these bulbs are hooked up to the Amazon Echo, so I can just ask Alexa to turn on whichever lights I want. Of course, they can also be controlled from your smartphone. Smart bulbs are still pretty expensive. It cost me the best part of £300 to kit out this floor with them, but the amount of control they offer, along with cool things like motion sensors so you never have to worry about leaving them on, not to mention the voice control, is kind of worth it in my opinion. So there we have it, that was my full room tour for 2017. I do hope you all enjoyed it. I have got a few upgrades planned for 2018, along with possibly a new PC build for you guys. So feel free to subscribe if you're not already, so you can keep up to date with that. Thanks again, guys, for all the support. I really do appreciate it. It's been an incredible journey so far. 5,000 subscribers is such an insane milestone for me, and I look forward to seeing what the future has to offer. Thanks for watching today, guys. I'll catch you all in the next one.